JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 29th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It lost the most ground versus SEK, NOK, CHF and the Euro, while it gained slightly only against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the greenback and the yen suggests that the markets may have traded in a risk-on manner yesterday, but the strengthening of the franc points otherwise. Therefore, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Now, here, all but two of the major EU and US indices traded in the green, with the exceptions being Germany's DAX and the UK FTSE 100. That said, appetite softened during the Asian session today. Although Japan's Nikkei and China Shanghai composite gained, Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI fell. Now, it seems that better than expected earnings remained the main driver behind the equity markets yesterday, despite the economic agenda, including an ECB decision. European stocks were boosted by food and technology stocks, with beer brewer Anheuser-Busch searching after a surprise rise in third quarter profit, and fresh IT service provided Capgemini adding 6% on strong earnings and outlook. Later in the US, the S&P 500 and Nasdaq hit fresh record highs, partly aided by gains in tech giants Apple and Amazon, which reported earnings after the closing bell, as well as by solid results from firms including Caterpillar and Merck. Having said that, though, both Apple and Amazon slid in after hours due to investors' disappointment after their earnings announcement. Now, as we already noted, yesterday we had an ECB monetary policy decision. The bank kept its policy settings unchanged, as was widely anticipated, while there was no material change in the accompanying statement. However, at the press conference following the decision, ECB President Lagarde highlighted that although the surging inflation is still expected to be temporary, it is now anticipated to last longer than previously expected. She also added that, in her view, PEP will end in March, but we believe that a more formal announcement on that may come in December. Nonetheless, she added that our analysis certainly does not support that the conditions of our forward guidance are satisfied at the time of liftoff as expected by markets, nor any time sooner thereafter. This was mainly an effort to push back expectations over an interest rate increase next year. Remember that ahead of the meeting, there were expectations that the ECB could hike rates by 25 basis points next year. Now, having said all that, though, it seems that she failed to do so. She failed to cool down expectations over higher interest rates. And this is evident by the spike higher in the euro, which gained more than 100 pips during the against the US dollar during the press conference. Perhaps market participants focused more on the comment that inflation could stay elevated more than previously thought, and judged that this will eventually force Lagarde and her colleagues to push the hike button earlier than they now themselves anticipate. Now, today, Euro traders will turn their attention to Eurozone's preliminary CPIs for October. The headline rate is expected to have risen to 3.7% year-over-year from 3.4%, while the HICP, excluding energy and food rate, is forecast to have stayed unchanged at 1.9%, just a tick below the ECB's new objective of 2%. In our view, such numbers will add credence to the view that inflation could stay elevated for longer than previously thought, and may encourage euro traders to add to bets with regards to an earlier rate hike. This could keep the euro supported for a while more, especially against the yen. And the reason is because in the midst of generally rising bond yields around the globe, the Bank of Japan still keeps a lid on its own bond yields. However, we are reluctant to call for a long-lasting recovery against the US dollar and the British pound, as both the Fed and the Bank of England meet next week, with market participants eager to find out whether the Fed will taper and signal that interest rate hikes could take place next year, and whether the Bank of England will indeed push the hike button at that gathering, or at least before year end. Now, as for the rest of today's events, in the US, personal income and spending for September are coming out, alongside the core PCE index for the month, while from Canada we have the monthly GDP for August. Personal income is expected to have declined somewhat, while spending is anticipated to have increased, but at a slower pace than in August. The core PCE index, the Fed's favorite inflation metric, is forecast to have ticked up to 3.7% year over year from 3.6%, something that could add more credence to the case of a tapering start by the Fed at next week's gathering. As for Canada's GDP, the forecast points to a 0.7% month over month rebound after a 0.1% slide in July. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.